My name is Giuseppe, they call me Giao, Randazzo. I come from Italy, a small town in Sicily, and I'm born in a small village. Come to Australia in the 60s. I decided to come to Australia because all of my many of my friends used to emigrate to different places. I want to see a little bit more, I want to see the world, I want to see a bigger city, and I want to see what is going on around the world. So I really was looking forward to go somewhere. I decided to come to Darwin. I have some relatives here, and I'm pleased I did that. And from the moment I arrived here, and like Darwin so much, I've spent over 50 years here now. When I came in the 60s, Darwin wasn't very much at all. No air conditions, no ceiling fence, and back in those days was everything limited. I had to live in a different way. I had to learn to live by myself. Oh, well, it was very hard to be away from my mother and father because I've been living all the time with them. And also it was a bit hard to live from the place you're born, because you never forget a place you're born. No matter how long you stay away from a place, you still always still get good memories. It was a little bit difficult. You had a bit homesick, we call it, and for the first 12 months or so. But after 12 months, things started improving, and then we started looking around if anything I can do by myself and get a little contract. I tried, and it was difficult, but I was willing to work. To work hard, doing anything, just to get somewhere. I find that very, very nice old architect working for the Department of Construction back in those days. I went and see him if he could help me out to costing jobs because I had no idea how to do it. And they must have seen that I was genuine, willing to work. I told them I'm willing to work, but doing prices and costing a job, I got no knowledge. Like if you could help me for a while, no? And he did it for a couple of years, and they put him in the right direction, and just keep going from there. Then we carry on that until the 70s. My business was going well. I was employing quite a few people. I was doing a little bit bigger projects. And in 1974, my firm was going very well, employing 60, 70 people back in those days. Of course, then the Cyclone Tracy is coming, and things change again. People didn't know what to do. A lot of people left Darwin then. And everybody was confused if Darwin would be rebuilt or if Darwin doesn't be built anymore. That was about 2 weeks later when the Prime Minister came to Darwin. He said that Darwin would be rebuilt. So the people got the confidence again to stay here, keep it working. The insurance companies started paying money, people rebuilt their houses, the government building a new contract, schools and houses. So there's a completely new life started. There was a lot of work, and I was very busy then with the projects, but we managed. We went through that, and after Saturn, the system changed completely, a different way to construct. Different way to do things, and so I went with that. And today we got a very good system to building strong buildings here down. For the next 45 years, my company went improving all the time. I reached somewhere in employing nearly 200 people. I was very happy with that, but now we're getting a bit older. And things change again. in 1978, I went to get married. After nearly 10 years I was here in Down, I decided to go back and see my relatives for Christmas. When I got there, one day I went to the mess, and I see this young, good-looking girl. And because I knew the family before I left, they come and said hello, you know. And when I went back home, I said, I like you very much. And so sort of started from there. But then because I had to come back here, and Serena was supposed to start at university, so I didn't go very far. But otherwise, keep in mind for the Beatitis later, we decide to engage and get married. We're very happy, and we got a good family. We got 2 daughters married at the end down, and we got 4 grandchildren, and we live all very, very close here. Back in those days, when they were little, and I had a lot of work, a lot of projects, I would say all right through the Northern Territory. And used to leaving very early in the morning, come back later in the evening, stay away for a few days, and I was a very busy person then. But my wife spent a lot of time. She dedicated to the kids teaching Italian. They come up with a very good Italian language. They have no problem to traveling around, got to Italy, talk to relatives, etc., etc. I live here so long, yes, that's over 50s, and I think to live in this country is a country can offer good quality life, but of course, I think a person got to be prepared to work, got to be honest, respectable, and this is very important, and to respect and be respected. I think they create a good friendship in this country is a very big value. All of my family is here, of course, and I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to raise my family here, but I will never forget my native country, of course. I like to go back there if I can, see my relatives, see my friends. We want still there because the matter where it is, never forget the country where you're born. That's the way I feel. But the country I will live, spend the rest of my life, will be Down. Down I will consider the best place in the world.
Paese mio che stai sulla collina, disteso come un vecchio addormentato, la noia, l'abbandono, il niente son la tua malattia. Paese mio ti lascio, io vado via. Che sarà, che sarà, che sarà? Che sarà della mia vita, chi lo sa? So far tutto o forse niente, da domani se vedrà. Che sarà, sarà quel che sarà. Gli amici miei son quasi tutti via, e gli altri partiranno dopo me. Peccato perché stavo bene in loro compagnia, ma tutto passa, tutto se ne va. Che sarà, che sarà, che sarà, che sarà della mia vita, chi lo sa? Con me porti alla chitarra se la notte piangerò, niña di paese suonerò a
amore mio, ti bacio sulla bocca, che fu la fonte del mio primo amore. Ti do l'appuntamento come quando non lo so, passo soltanto